Hello guys, this is Pardeep from CompuFace.com. Today we are going to see a tutorial about external threading. First of all, click on the select working directory and I'm going to create a new folder in the desktop named as external threading. And click on OK. I'm going to create a new file that is of type part and subtype as solid. Uncheck the use default template because we are going to use a standard template for it. I'm naming it as phi_external_threading. Make sure you remove the use default template and click OK. I'm using the standard template as MMNS part solid. Dimension is mm and you can use inch if you use inch as the dimension and click OK. Next, I'm going to sketch the solid in which I'm going to do the external threading, and it's going to be a cylinder, so I'm choosing circle as the cross section of dimension 100 mm and click OK. And I'm going to extrude it for a height of say 150 mm, then click OK. Now refit to your screen. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a profile for the external threading, which is similar to that of the helical sweep. I'm going to give the references as one of the references as the curved surface and the other as other two as the top and the bottom of the cylinder, and click close. Then I'm going to take the line, which is nothing but the profile, and no need to give the dimensions as the references are already set. So you have got the profile. Then I'm going to use helical sweep under the option of sweep, and I'm going to set the profile and the axis of rotation and the pitch to be as 10 mm. Then I'm going to sketch the cross section, which is nothing but it depends upon what cross section you want. First I will draw a square thread. For that I'm going to draw a cross section of square, and you have to note one thing which is important. The cross section drawn should always be in the inner part of the solid or the gray part, and the dimension which I'm giving is pitch by 2, which is nothing but 10 by 2, which is 5 mm. And when I give remove material, you can clearly visualize the thread formed in the solid part. Now you can use your middle mouse button to rotate the solid. If it is not clear, you can use shade with edges in the view options. For example, if I'm going to change the cross section, I'm going to change it to a metric thread, then the cross section is not the square one. It has to be a triangular one. So I'm just changing the square cross section into triangular one, and click on OK. Now you can clearly visualize what type of thread is formed. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. If you don't like, show me a comments below. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel. Please visit us at www.compuffice.com. Thank you.